glad you joined me again. I have a lot of topics to talk about today, so let's just get started. First of all, I don't know if you noticed, but I've been pretty consistent with my videos, and I've been posting one every Sunday and every either Wednesday or Thursday, depending on when Omri lives. Omri, my friend who's staying with me during the week, leaves on either Wednesday or Thursday, and I get the house to myself for a few hours till Tomer gets there. And on Sunday, as today, I just a couple hours ago drove Tomer to the train station. He's going back to the center. So I wanted to tell you that in 3 weeks from today, on July 18th, I won't be making a video. The reason is that we're moving that day. Yay, we set a date. We're moving in to our new apartment in Petah Tikva, which is near the center of Israel. It's in the center of Israel. It's near Tel Aviv. So I just wanted to let you know that. I'm very excited. The little thing is, the reason I'm wearing glasses again is, again, because I have these allergies that make my eyes very sensitive and itchy, so I'm not going to put my contacts in. Plus, I'm going back to sleep right after I finish uploading my videos, because the past few days I haven't been falling asleep very easily. I've been sleeping all right. I still wake up and have to pee in the middle of the night, but it's usually closer to the morning, so I get a little more normal sleep. But the past few days, it's been Tomer's already sleeping and snoring next to me, and I'm still reading a book an hour and a half later. It's a very good book that I'm reading right now. It's in Hebrew, but I just twist and turn every few pages, and my hands hurt because I'm holding the book like this. I'm on my side. And my legs hurt because just from being on the side, each leg hurts for different reasons on each side. And so that's why I still have my glasses on. And I'm again on my ball because my legs really, really hurt. Yesterday, I'll tell you about, I want to talk to you about balance, finding balance. Because yesterday I went for a walk in the morning. I woke up early and it was really nice out. And I haven't been able to walk this week because it was so hot here. I think it was over 100 Fahrenheit. I don't know exactly. I need to calculate that to know. But it was 35 or 40 degrees here in Be'er Sheva. Whoa, in the south. You got to keep your balance on the ball as well. Oh. And I went for a walk, and I have two, you know, routes that I usually take. One is a bit shorter, it's about 15 minutes walking, 20 if I'm really, really slow. And the other one is maybe 25, 30 minutes long. And I remember I was getting to the point where I have to decide if I'm taking the shorter route or the longer route. And I was considering, you know, I was thinking in my head, what's, you know, which is better. I was really in a walking kind of mood. I had my music and the weather was really nice and I wanted to walk. But I knew that if I walked too much, and I hadn't been walking during the week, so my legs have gotten a bit weaker, I knew that it might hurt after. So, and my legs were hurting during the walk as well. But they always do, so it's not really, but I did need to, I kind of knew that I was pushing it. And I was right, I was pushing it. I got home and about 3 or 4 hours after I finished my walk, my right leg decided that it was jealous of my left leg that has been getting so much attention because it's been hurting so much. And it wanted to also be in the spotlight. So my right hip, when I was, after we had breakfast and I went back to take a nap, read and take a nap, it takes me a while, my right leg started throbbing with pain. It was just pumping from the right here and my back and my hip all the way to my toes, and it's still not really gone. But when I woke up, I thought it was calmer. But 10 minutes after I woke up, it was right back throbbing, and my right knee was really, really weak. And every time I would sit down and stand up, I'd have to use something to, because if I put too much, if I used my knee too much when I got up, it was, whew. Every time I got up, I was like, ow, ow. Every time I sat down, I fell to the seat because I had to keep my knee straight so it doesn't hurt so bad. So, if you guys have balancing problems and you want to share, I would love to hear, and I'm sure everyone else would, so feel free. Next thing regarding the move that is happening in 3 weeks, Tomer and I made a list during the weekend of everything that we have to do before we move, the things we have to do regarding the new apartment, everything I have to do here, and close all the loose ends. So... I think we made the list also because we're both very organized, at least mentally, and we like to know where we stand and know what we have to do, and we like working with lists, but also because for me it was kind of a way to de-stress. This whole thing is very stressful. Every time I have too many things in my mind, and I, with the fibro fog and the concentration problems and the memory problems, I always lose things, and it keeps me stressed if I know that I'm losing things. So when I write it down, it helps me de-stress. So if you have any de-stressing tips, anything to help the stress go away or help you cope with the stress better, I'd also love for you to share it. Maybe we'll talk about it more later. One thing I wanted to say about... you know, ever since I started this video blog, which I'm loving, my hands have been feeling a bit better because when I was writing, it would be, I think I told you, like 4 pages long of typing, Hebrew and English, or half and half. And now that I'm not doing that, my hands feel a little better. I have a little more strength for the schoolwork. My legs aren't better, but my hands are better. I do miss writing. I miss writing really bad. Now Tomer writes, and hopefully he'll post another post about being a partner of a fibroid like me. But I do miss writing very much. So I wanted to tell you that. And I hope that when I finish with the whole move and school and everything, I can go back to writing some of it and vlogging some of it. So now I just wanted to give you a little glance into the future. I have finished one paper, so I only have one more paper this week to do and 2 tests next week. I'm very excited because then I'll be done with school, really. And then I also hope that before we leave here, I'll be able to do a video blog with Rina, who I told you about in my friend's montage. She was helping me cook on Friday, and it turned out that I was just telling her what to do most of the time. I was still on my legs, but my hands weren't hurting as bad from the cooking, so that was really nice. So we're going to talk a little bit about what it's like to be my friend. And also Omri, which you have heard about plenty of times. He and I are gonna do hopefully a video blog when we finish all the tests. So I'm very excited about that. I want you to see not only how I cope, but how people around me are handling this, because I think that's important, and it might also help to show other people that around you how you feel and how you need other people to behave around you, because I feel like my friends and my family are just the best. Couldn't imagine being more supported by my surroundings. So that's it for today. I hope you have a pain-free week. And Jean Renee, and I wanted to say hi to you and to Juliana. I love getting your pictures. So I hope you all have a pain-free week, and I hope to see you next time. Hey guys.
To save me, come on.